500 calories a day for 7 days to lose 1 pound. That's 3,500 calories that you have to burn in cardio, weight training, or vigorous exercise. I'm not talking about, you know, taking a walk with your grandmother that's in a walker. I'm talking about doing vigorous exercise to burn that kind of calorie. But if they say an average spin class, an average 50-minute spin class, you'll burn 500 calories. And that's pretty intense. Okay, so you do that 5 times a week, or 7 times a week, burning 3,500 calories, not eating any more than what you normally do, you're going to lose 1 pound a week. The numbers work. If my numbers are off here and there a little bit, it's okay. I'm just giving you a good mental visual on what foods and workouts do. So what's a cookie made out of? Let me see. Sugar and flour. How coincidental, two of the killers. Now, if it has chocolate chips in it, oh, more sugar. So now you're compounding, basically, three types of sugar. You know that flour is a sugar? Flour. White bread is made out of white flour, right? Well, what happened? That's carbs. That's all categorized as carbohydrates. When you eat a slice of bread, bread goes into your system. If it's white bread, it's a simple carbohydrate. Why simple? Because you can eat and eat and eat and eat. You can eat pasta. Oh my God, it's so good. Garlic bread? Huh. Forget it, I can eat a whole basket of that. Hey, guess what? If you don't work out to burn off those 500 or 600 calories you just ate, or 1,000 calories and eat Italian, that turns into sugar in your body. The body has two types of storages, sugar store, fat store. Now sugar store, if you do excessive exercise, that storage in your body of sugar will deplete, and then you get the craving again, oh, I need more sugar, basically at the same time every day. At 2 in the morning when you stand in front of the fridge and you want something sweet, and it happens day after day after day, okay, that's an addiction already. Okay. Now, if you don't burn that sugar, you don't do exercise, guess what? You're still eating sugars. That's got to go somewhere. What happens? It goes here and turns into fat. And more, and more, and more. Your sugar stores will only handle a certain amount of package. Your fat stores will grow and grow and grow. And that's the way people gain weight. Very hard to lose it. Unless 80%, which is your diet, what you're eating, you start reducing that. When we get to food and exercise, portion control is the best. Why? Because you can still have your teaspoon of sugar. Not a cookie which has 10 teaspoons of sugar. Okay? But a little bite. Satisfied me, that was it. Portion control. You're still eating a cookie, taking a bite out of it, that's it. Put the rest away. Leave it for another day. And then your workouts, it affects your workout. You have to build muscle, and you have to build a lot of muscle as a woman or a guy in order for that muscle to start burning your fat. Muscle burns fat, not sugar. Speed, running on a treadmill, on an elliptical, on a bike, that's all sugar. What happens when your sugar is depleted? Well, you pass out. You know, it just happens. You know, passing out is no good because when you open your eyes, you never know who's going to be on top of you. So, you know, it's just not a good thing, okay? You want an equal balance. So, for anybody that wants to do exercise, it's a good thing. I don't care if you hold little 2 pounds. It's not an embarrassment. It's an achievement. It's an achievement while you're in the gym working out, doing something. And then when you go home, you go to eat, you know what? Fill that plate up and eat it all. You know? And if you have kids that do the same thing or a little overweight, it's even worse. You know? You can't tell a kid, hey, there's starving children around the world, eat everything on your plate. When I raised my kids, if they weren't hungry and they left the whole plate, I'd say fine. Kids don't starve. When they're hungry, they're going to eat. You know? So that's the way you got to take it. So, and I do train. I have a lot of classes with little kids. I have seniors.
not happy. Teenagers,
young adults, like Derek, Carissa. I mean, Carissa had to hang out with me for how long?
10 years.
Whatever. And she lost all this weight. And everybody was complimenting her. And she left me and went to her cookie. Now her and her cookie's her boyfriend, by the way, just like she was. Which is not a good thing. Derek, you're doing a really good job. Carissa, you're doing a really good job on that treadmill.